The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is. 7th chapter, text number 2 through 5, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 16th of June, 1974, in Germany.
So, this was a discussion between Arjuna and Krishna in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. So, the subject of discussion was that although the battle was declared, Arjuna, when he actually found that on the other side there are my relatives, how he could slay them. Krishna advised that everyone must execute his prescribed duty without consideration of any personal loss or gain. According to Vedic civilization, there are 4 divisions of the society. Everywhere the same divisions are there, all over the world. This is very natural. Just like we can study from our own body. There is head, there is arms, there is belly, and there is leg. Similarly, in the society, there must be a class of man who should be considered as brain. Another class of man should be there who will protect the society from danger. Another class of man will be expert in producing food grains and give protection to the cows and make trade. So, and the rest class of men, namely, who cannot work as brain, neither can work as protector from danger, nor they can produce food grains or give protection to the cows, they are called Sudras. As you cannot avoid to make your body complete, the brain department, the arms department, the belly department, and the walking or working department. So, Arjuna belongs to the group of men who was meant for giving protection to the society. So, when he was declining to fight, at that time Krishna gave him advice that it is your duty to fight. So, generally, killing is not good at all. But when there is enemy, aggressor, then to kill the aggressor is not sin. So, the other party in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, they became aggressor to the Arjuna's party. Now, this is the setup of the Bhagavad Gita. The real purpose is to instruct Arjuna about spiritual understanding. So, spiritual understanding means, first of all, to know what is spirit. If you do not know what is spirit, then where is spiritual understanding? People are too much engrossed with the body. That is called materialism. But when you understand what is spirit and you act accordingly, that is called spiritualism. So, Arjuna was hesitating to fight with the other party because he had bodily relationship with them. So, between Arjuna and Krishna, there was discussion, but that was friendly discussion. Therefore, when Arjuna understood that simply friendly discussion could not solve the problem, he became his disciple. Arjuna surrendered to Krishna, Srishastriham Sadhvam Parvannam. My dear Krishna, so long we are talking as friends. Now I become your regular disciple. Kindly save me by instruction, what I have to do. Therefore, when this stage was arrived, Krishna is advising Arjuna as follows. Sri Bhagavan was. Now it is said here, who is saying to Arjuna? The author or the recorder of Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita was spoken by Krishna. It was a discussion between Krishna and Arjuna, and it was recorded by Vyasadeva, and later on it became a book. This time when we speak, it is recorded, and later on it is published as a book. Therefore, in this book, it is said, Bhagavan Uvasa, Vyasadeva is the writer. He does not say that I speak. He says, Bhagavan Uvasa. And the Supreme Personality of Godhead said. So Krishna is accepted by the authority as Bhagavan or the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And what is Bhagavan? Bhagavan means that one who is fully equipped with six opulences. Fully equipped with all opulences means Bhagavan is the richest personality. How much rich Bhagavan or God is, we can understand that we are proud of possessing a few acres of land. And Bhagavan means who is the proprietor of the whole universe. Therefore, he is considered the richest. Similarly, he is considered the strongest. And similarly, he is considered the wisest. And similarly, he is the most beautiful personality. In this way, when you find a person, the richest, the most beautiful, the most wise, the strongest, in this way when you find, that is Bhagavan or God. So when Krishna was present on this planet, he proved all these opulences possessed by him. Take for example that everyone marries, but Krishna, being the Supreme Person, he married 16,108 women. But it is not that he remained one husband for 16,000 wives. He made arrangement for providing the 16,000 wives in different palaces. Each palace, that is described, they are made of first-class marble stone and furniture made of ivory, and the sitting place made of very nice soft cotton. This way there is description. And the outward compound, there are many flower trees. Not only that, he also expanded himself into 16,000 expansion, personal expansion. And he was living in that way with each and every wife. So it is not very difficult task for God. God is said to be situated everywhere. So within our vision, if he is situated in 16,000 homes, what is the difficulty for him? So here it is said, Sri Bhagavan Uvasa, the most powerful authority is speaking. Therefore, whatever he says, it is to be taken as true. In our this conditional life, just like we are living under material condition, we have got four defects. We commit mistake. We are illusion. And we want to cheat also. And our senses are imperfect. So knowledge received from a person who is infected with four kinds of deficiencies is not perfect. So when you receive knowledge from a person who is transcendental to all these four kinds of defects, that is perfect knowledge. Modern scientists, they theorize that it may be like this, it may be like that, but that is not perfect knowledge. So if you speculate with your imperfect senses, what is the value of that knowledge? It may be partial knowledge, but that is not perfect knowledge. Therefore, our process of receiving knowledge is to receive it from the perfect person. Therefore, we are receiving knowledge from Krishna, Bhagavan, the most perfect. And therefore, our knowledge is perfect. Just like a child, he may be imperfect, but if his father says, by their child, this is called spectacle. So, if the child speaks, this is spectacle, that knowledge is perfect. Because the child does not make research to find out knowledge. He asks his father or mother, what is this, daddy, what is this, mother? And the mother says, my dear child, this is this. Another example can be given, that is, if the child does not, in childhood, he does not know who is his father, that he cannot make any research work. If he makes research work to find out his father, he'll never find out his father. But if he asks his mother, who is my father, and the mother says, he is your father, that is perfect. Therefore, knowledge of God, who is beyond your sense perception, how can you know? Therefore, you have to know from God Himself, or His eternity. So here Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is speaking, and that is the final authority. He says to Arjuna as follows. He says, asachyananusuchastam pagyavadam subhasasthi. My dear Arjuna, you are talking like very learned scholar, but you are lamenting on a subject matter which you should not do. Gatasun agatasun sa nanusu chanti pandita. Gatasun means this body, when it is dead or when it is alive. Bodily conception of life is foolishness. So no learned man takes serious consideration of the God. Therefore, in the Vedic literature it is said that one who is in the bodily concept of life, he is nothing more than an animal. That's why at the present moment, without knowledge of the self, the whole world is going on under the bodily concept of life. The bodily concept of life is there amongst the animals. The cats and dogs, they are very proud of becoming a big cat or big dog. Similarly, if a man also becomes similarly proud that I am big American, big German, big, what is the difference? But that is actually going on. And therefore they are fighting like cats and dogs. So we can discuss more now, tomorrow. Yeah.